Good morning. I am Dr. Sudhir, Assistant Professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering of Engineering College, Bharatpur. Today, we are going to describe the basic fundamental concept of vestigial sideband suppressed carrier of analog and digital communication subject. So basically, how the VSBC signal is illustrated and from how motivation is obtained from SSBHC signal and DSBC signal. Basically, VSBHC modulation system is actually a compromise between DSBHC and SSBHC modulation system. In other words, we can say that it is optimum choice in which the advantage of DSBHC and SSBHC modulation system have been explored. As a matter of fact, the generation of VSB modulation signal is easier than other modulation signal such as conventional AM, DSBHC and SSBHC. Its bandwidth is only slightly higher than single sideband signal but considerably less than DSBHC signal. Single sideband modulation is rather most suitable for the transmission of voice signal because of energy gap that exists in the frequency spectrum of the voice signal between 0 and few hundred hertz. On the other hand, the signal contains frequency component at extremely low frequency. The USB and LSB of the transmitted signal tend to meet at carrier frequency. It becomes very difficult to isolate one sideband from other. For wideband information signal, SSB is difficult to implement. Basically, SSBHC signal is generated with the help of two methods. First, frequency discrimination and second, phase discrimination. So, with the help of the frequency discrimination, filter must have a sharp cutoff near the frequency FC so as to able to eliminate the one sideband without disturbing the other. When we use phase discrimination, we require Hilbert transform, which are difficult to implement if message signal has large bandwidth. So, in VSB modulation, SSB is difficult to implement, then we can use vestigial sideband modulation. Although VSB signal is implemented by frequency discrimination, but filtering process does not completely eliminate the unwanted band. In fact, some of desired band is also partially filtered out. So here we are describing the VSBHC signal generation process. Basically, VSB modulator and its frequency response, which are shown in figure below. The response of VSBHC filter is denoted by HVSBF. We notice a transition band around the frequency FC. So basically here we are showing the waveform of the vestigial sideband suppressed carrier. And first figure show the message spectrum which has bandwidth minus BM to BM. Now, in the second figure, lower sideband and upper sideband both are shown in case of the double SC signal. But here we are describing the concept of the vestigial sideband suppressed carrier. Then we retain the principal band and the lower band contribute the vestigial sideband. However, either sideband can be used to form the principal band in practice. So in this example, we have to design a filter which has gain of k amplitude for all frequency, and that frequency lies from fc plus x, which is known as passband. For the frequency which greater than fc but it less than fc plus x, and it shows that the we are residing the principal band and gain is less than k, so some losses compared to the pass band occur. For the frequency below carrier frequency but greater than fc minus x, then filter gain is not zero, otherwise some of the other sideband frequency component are passed by filter, and SVSB has a vestigial sideband. The bandwidth of the vestigial sideband signal, and that is equal to BM plus X. Generally, we are trying to reduce the bandwidth compared to the DSBSC signal, which is X is smaller than BM. So this is the mathematical calculation of transform of VSBAC signal. Here capital S denoted the Fourier transform, and F is indicated the F domain. So SVSBF, that is equal to SDSBSC multiply some generated filter, and this is defined as HVSBF. So after simplification and some given the modification, we are obtaining the final transform version of VSBSC signal, that is equal to AC upon 4 M plus M minus FC H plus VSBF plus AC upon 4 M minus F minus FC H plus VSBF plus AC upon 4 M plus F plus FC H minus VSBF plus AC 4 M minus F plus FC multiply HVSB minus, where H plus VSB and H minus VFC is defined as by using this formula. Now, after generating the VSBAC signal at the transmitter side, now it is required to transmit over the wireless communication channel with the help of the transmitter. So, after transmitting the VSBAC signal from the transmitter, now this signal is able to decode at the receiver end with help of the demodulation process. Basically, demodulation process of any signal is executed at the receiver side, which is done with help of the some local carrier oscillated at the receiver side, and the motto of demodulation is to extract the message signal from the modulated signal which is transmitted from the receiver side. So this is the block diagram of the demodulation of VSBAC signal. Here the receive signal is known as incoming modulated signal and incoming VSBAC signal, which is defined as small SVSBT. Now after generating the local oscillator at the receiver side, we are giving the equation of local oscillator carrier AR cos 2 pi FCT, and after multiplication of this local oscillator with incoming modulated signal, we just receive the VSBSC signal as incoming signal, and with help of the local oscillator and the incoming wave, with the help of the low pass filter, we are just decode the message signal which are used at the transmitter side. And after that, if we want to ZT and that is equal to GMT, then we need to impose a constraint on the frequency response of that modulator. So this is the frequency response of signal which is obtained at the receiver side.